a most pleasant evening. There has been a clamour to get inside the ground tonight for a much anticipated game. The roads outside of the stadium have been bumper to bumper with traffic. The car parks are full. There is a torrent of humankind making its way from the nearby station, and we expect every seat to be filled. An atmosphere of great expectation and excitement. Down here calling upon Corinthians from all corners of this impressive modern arena. We have already started here. Back in, pushes it out wide, looks to clip it forward. That intervention was very necessary. Aimed low and direct. He acknowledges that he should have come up with something better there.
The movement was good, but the pass lacked authority, a cause of mild frustration.
Now it's D'Alessandro. D'Alessandro, PLASIL, going for goal! Goal! Well, a deflection may or may not have made a difference. Little matter, it is his. Forward it goes. Played into space out wide. Hardly anything between the sides, and it's 1-0. Certainly caught him there, it's a free kick. D'Alessandro plays it through. He's got away. Group defending, it's been repelled. Wants to get it forward quickly. No position to make that interception. Forward it goes. And it's PLASIL. Have a good movement up front.
Yeah, they're playing with a false nine. No one's really holding a fixed position up there.
How does that work?
Well, I think it's an attempt to just confuse this defence with constant interchange and different movement.
D'Alessandro. And he's there to cut it out.
Yeah, that's top defending and preventing him turning, which can open up many possibilities.
Hit long and direct. And he's onside. Looking to shoot. It's a goal! Well, from right in front of goal, there was no way he was going to miss.
It's rarely a problem when that much time is afforded. Nobody sensed where the danger was lurking, and the finish was made a lot easier.
Certainly made things interesting.
Well, what a convincing response to going behind. They've got all the momentum now.
D'Alessandro turns and goes back, shakes the chutes. Promising move that. Good inroads into enemy territory, but no joy. Into the middle. Keeper goes long. And it's D'Alessandro. Boots it to safety. Ball's loose. Who's getting there? Drilled in low. It's gone a long way up and away. Interesting game here, very, very watchable. Two goals, one each. Kashima Antlers head into the dressing room after a half in which we've seen two goals, one each. The game right on edge.
I don't think he knew either. first touch to die for, and it set him up beautifully. So now we're going to get those changes we have been expecting. So nobody can get in behind. Deftly done. Shoots! It's there! And the comeback is complete! And how about the timing of the pass and run? They've worked it before and no doubt they'll work it again. Activity down on the touchline. It seems there's going to be a change. Well, this is what we've been waiting for. Yeah, for me, this team seems to find it easier to attack than defend, but now they're going to need to dig in at the back a bit. Seal. Played back in. Stuff, this is better. This isn't the time to talk about risks now, Jim, is it? They just have to hurl everything at it and hope for a break. Just has to be done. Just brushed off the ball there. Neymar trying to run down the left wing. And it's Neymar. He's got the ball glued to his feet. Chances. Well, it was deliberate, it was cynical, and you have to understand the frustration of being denied a clear opportunity, but it had to be done. The keeper is trying to organise his defence here. He knows this could be pivotal. He's shaping up to have a crack from here. To the left it goes. It's PLASIL. He's tried one. Can it come back out? They've scored. There seemed no way back, but they are level. He was really quick to react to the initial save, and he has his reward. Well, that's not the best attempt by the keeper, and he's just paid the ultimate price, hasn't he?
Quite a thriller this one's become.
Well, they're back on level terms, so the guessing game goes on. As to what will happen from here, I've no idea.
Kashima Antlers still contemplating when to use their last remaining substitute. Over to the left.
Corinthians merit full marks for their attitude and application in trying to win this. It means an awful lot, obviously.
Driving on, a real charge here.
Look, this can still go either way. It might be flowing one way, but there's still time for some ebb.
It's a brilliant interception.
Concentration levels are very good, and so is the commitment. This game could get you.
He's through, and all of Neymar! In it goes! And the game is well and truly turned on its head!
I think he just thought about trying his look from further out there, but why bother when you can worm your way through a defence like that? It's terrific play to get through and score.
Change that was in the offing. Last one allowed.
I think you have to admire his willingness to keep plugging away, but the manager has done him a big favour, I think, by taking him off. You know, he was looking very, very leggy.
Kashima Antlers take the lead.
No doubt as to who has the momentum here now. The only doubt is how many is coming. Sink included.
And that has been clubbed away. Time for a change of personnel. He's got options in the box if he gets his head up. Of running down the clock now. Lovely feet. He's got away. And he's cut it out. Well, that's where he wants it. And that is that. Well, somehow they turned it round. Every ounce of energy, emotional, physical, mental, is spent. That is some win. Any reflections on what you've seen, Jim?
Yeah, we knew there was a sizable gap in the quality of both squads, and the story was told in predictable fashion.
So thank you very much, Jim, for joining me. That brings us to the end of our coverage. So from us both, a very good evening.
to you on this most pleasantly clear evening. As you can see, we are getting through the pre-match formalities and processes, the players coming onto the field for the usual fanfare and handshakes and so on. Conditions absolutely perfect, temperatures are kind enough, it is an absolute picture under the floodlights here, and the match that follows will to follow suit. Everything you see is in green. Green, of course, the colour of Palmeiras. Got on the way here pretty promptly. And the finish! Big moment! Massive goal!
Listen, the big names earn their reputations for precisely the reason we've just seen. They have a habit of making their presence felt. And here we are, early stages. He struck wood, and he looks hungry for more.
Junior thoughts.
I just think it's clever positioning for clever movement, but when all of that is synchronized with the right pass, that's what happens.
Goes long. Now, working very hard to get it wide now, Jim.
I think they've decided to concentrate on working the flanks to help the production line. It's
he's gone for it! It's in!
Now, looking back at that, that's how you play on the counter. Quick and decisive and ruthless with the finish. I thought it was a stunning, stunning breakaway.
To the game.
Yeah, it's always a dangerous time when you've just scored. You can easily lose focus and then bang, and take back again.
It's a great gallop down the right-hand side. Here it comes. Options out wide, room for a shot. An intervention was very necessary. That's a corner. Yes, it is. Played it short. It's a brilliant interception. Gets into a dangerous position. Simeone.
it's on a... Is it in?
He's there to make a great save.
Oh, that's a sparkling save. Absolutely sparkling. His reflexes were ultra sharp.
Melo has created one goal already.
Felipe Melo. A good ball. Good running with the ball. Can they build on it? As he picks him out. Oh, he's in! Simeone. The odds on him missing from there were very slim.
Yeah, teamwork was key to that. A beautiful piece of engineering to set him free in the box.
Commend the wing plate, but I have to condemn the defending. They've got to stop the cross. Direct, going through. What a corner here. It's been taken short. And he's cut it out.
To come back. Certainly I didn't see that coming, nor I think did many in this crowd.
And we are up to the break.
Well, what a half. It's been pulsating and totally absorbing. We're actually headed for a potential classic if this carries on. This is insanely good.
Very little in it. The score at half-time is 2-1. Probably into the second 45 minutes. It's hoisted clear.
Lucas Moura.
Ball's loose. Who's getting there? Oh, it's opened up nicely for him. Gorgeous control there.
And the shot! In it two to the good. They have breathing space.
Look, there just wasn't much of a gap to begin with, and to find it, I think it was a fine drive, and I don't think the keeper could have really planned for that. He's a bit unlucky in that instance.
So the lead now is two.
Look, it's a whole different ball game now, Peter, and it's a test of how they manage affairs from here.
Enrique goes looking, and it's Simeone.
Who's chasing?
Palmeiras keeping their men at arm's length here.
Yeah, I just think it's a conservative move to deny runners the opportunity of going beyond that rear guard.
It's always a good time to register and lay down an early marker in the second half. They clearly had exactly that in mind. Their business with absolutely right limits.
He acknowledges that he should have come up with something better there.
Was too timid to make it through the defence. It'll be noted and improved upon, I'm sure.
It's Saka. Felipe Melo gets it back.
Shima Atlas made a substitution yet.
Looks to clip it forward. Now the breakaway.
Clearance and very necessary.
Lucas Moura
breaks on here.
Trying to play it through.
Oh, that just required a bit more oomph to reach its target.
Yuri. And Simeone.
Fires it in low. Looking to shoot!
Fox has got rid of that.
Palmeiro pushes it out wide.
It's ball, who's going to get there?
There's a long ball.
Palmeiras playing almost as if they were trying to walk the ball in.
So now we're going to get those changes we have been expecting.
I think you have to admire his willingness to keep plugging away, but the manager has done him a big favour, I think, by taking him off. You know, he was looking very, very leggy.
Yuri.
Saka. And it's Okubo.
He's made sure that that won't get through. Forward it goes. Played out to the right. Dinks one in.
was right, the delivery wasn't. They can revisit that further on.
Simeone. And the weighted pass.
Has a pop! Yes! And the lead is extended still further.
Well, that always looked like the outcome.
It's almost criminal to see a defence fail to identify someone who thrives when it comes to shooting stats. They knew, and yet they didn't heed, and they paid the price and deserved it.
Time for a change in personnel.
Well, his stamina was called into question then. There's absolutely nothing wrong with his heart and the effort he put in. He was very willing, though, not quite able.
Kashima Antlers grab a three-goal lead. It's just too easy. Into the channel.
And he's there to cut it out.
Yuri plays it forward, dashing forward at pace. Shibasaki.
Simeone.
It's a clever pass. With Shibasaki.
The shot's on!
Out to the left it goes. Referee looks at his watch and blows his whistle. Well, that's bounce-back ability. Responding superbly to come from behind, shrugging off setbacks along the way, and determinedly getting there in the end. Your reflections then, Jim?
Yeah, we knew there was a sizable gap in the quality of both squads, and the story was told in predictable fashion.
My thanks to Jim alongside me, and as the fans make their way home, so must we. Good evening to you.